Why do you think so many restorations look fake? And what can you and your technician do to avoid this problem? I want to share with you two natural-looking restoration secrets that will help you overcome this problem. My name is Christian Coachman. I've been a ceramist for over 30 years, and I've been pursuing natural aesthetics since then. In this journey, among many other things, I founded Digital Smile Design and pioneered the DSD Natural Restoration concept. So the two secrets to achieve natural, beautiful smiles. One, color is important, but shapes are much more important. And two, when it comes to shapes, you cannot beat nature. So the key question is, how can we copy natural shapes into our restorations? And how can we leverage technology to make this magic happen? And this is why and how the DSD Natural Libraries were born. We need to be inspired by nature. We need to select beautiful natural dentitions. We need to acquire this data, and we need to incorporate this data into our softwares to design the restorations. This concept also relies on the idea of complete monolithic restorations, because the beauty comes from the surface. The beauty comes from the texture and morphology of the natural teeth that we're gonna use to design mock-ups, provisionals, dentures, implant restorations, veneers, and crowns. It all comes from the surface of the smile donors. So at the end of the day, this concept relies on us selecting beautiful natural dentition as donors and using high quality scanner technology to capture this data and import into our software. 12 years ago, we did the first ever completely digital natural libraries restorative case. We incorporated the scans of natural dentition into our CAD softwares, and we designed monolithic restorations with these natural libraries. Since then, of course, technology has drastically evolved. Scanners became much better to capture the details of the surface of objects and, of course, of the surface of natural dentition. The libraries that we used 12 years ago were captured by scanners, the best scanners that we had at that time, and they served us very, very well until now. But with all the evolution that happened in technology and, of course, on scanning technology, we decided that it's time for DSD Natural Libraries 2.0. Utilizing the best scanning technology to scan new natural dentitions and create a new library with even better morphology and even better texture. So as I mentioned, the key of this project was to select the ideal smile donors and select the best available scanner in the market. We did our homework, we did our work, we selected donors with beautiful natural dentition to cover all types of morphology and tooth age that we need to design all our cases. And we also did our homework when it comes to scanners. We tested all the major ones and we compared the resolution of them to choose the best one for this project. And the one we selected was Lumina from iTero. It gave us undoubtedly the best surface, the best definition, and the best texture for our libraries.
We choose the iTero Lumina because it gives us what matters most in restorative dentistry: accuracy. Its high density mesh captures tooth anatomy in a complete stunning detail, on par with the top scanners in the world. Thanks to its 6 cameras, multi-angle capture system, and 3x wider field of view, and 25 millimeters depth range, we get incredible precise data, even in the most challenging areas. And that level of details is exactly what we need to fit our new natural restorations library. Trying to obtain the best tooth texture and shape, we select the donators that fit in this project. We scanned them with the iTero Lumina. We took some intraoral photos We import all this data into our software. We analyze one by one. Inside the software, we create the segmentation because we want to work with each one of the tooth individually. We polish the mesh, we close it, we define the coordinates, so then we can modify each one of those mesh because we want to adapt to each one of the cases. We want to make it longer, we want to make it wider, we want to even modify a little bit the shape. So this is a trick to create a very precise and accurate final restorations for each one of our patients. We are using these natural textures and we are adapting to each one of the patients. That is something that definitely differentiates our lab.
The final message of this project is that we need to relearn how to appreciate natural beauty. We need to use all the best tools that we have in our hands to move away from fake looking smiles, fake looking teeth, morphology and texture. We need to leverage technology to help us make this magic happen. Through technology, we can copy paste nature into our work. So it's not anymore about trying to copy nature, but actually copy pasting it 100% into our restorations. So technology is the shortcut to connect dentistry back into natural looking smiles. So be inspired by nature. Challenge yourself, challenge your technician, and join us in this journey of natural-looking beauty.